What screams I'm a terrible person? Making your children upset in order to record it and post it for internet points. And yet they still continue to blow up over and over. It pisses me off so much. That's because there are just so many shitty trashy people. The audience for those channels includes a lot of kids. Walking around a store or public place playing music on a Bluetooth speaker full blast. Try walking around blasting the audio from a football game at a museum while ignoring your children as they dart all over the place. I recently got a train down to London and a guy who got on at the stop after me had some dumb quest game playing on his phone at full volume. Dirty looks didn't stop him, so I downloaded Candy Crush and played a couple of levels full volume. He got the message. You leveled up your passive aggressive skill as well. Abusing animals. Absolutely my first pick. If you hurt slash abuse animals, you are unequivocally a cowardly piece of shit. If differs on which ground though. Like say, fishing slash hunting for food. Sure you good. So long as it's as quick as possible. Kicking a stray cat slash dog for no good reason. You're a piece of shit that deserves whatever karma has in store for you. They just need to imagine how they would feel if they were getting abused. Most cats and dogs do not enjoy imagining such things. You have one of those Calvin pissing on bumper stickers. This and those plastic testicles some folks hang from their truck hitch. Truck nuts. Truck nuts. Feeling like you having a bad experience justifies you putting others through that same thing. But I had to do stupid dangerous shit for $3 an hour as an apprentice, yeah, and it turned you into someone who makes their apprentice do stupid shit instead of teaching proper safe methods. Leaving a shopping cart in the middle of a parking space in a packed parking lot. I used to be a cart jockey. I will never leave the cart anywhere other than the corral. I was never a cart jockey and I have been known to move trolleys that are not mine back to the proper zone. Also, cart jockey is a great term. And I'm imagining you as a tiny human in a check, colored outfit riding the trolleys around the car park. I was a lot thinner back then. If that counts for anything. Parking over two spaces. But what about four? Disassembling your car. Placing a part in each spot. And claiming the entire lot. Honestly. I wouldn't even be mad. Whoa. You disassembled your car for a private parking lot. To enter the store. And reassemble it again before even being able to load your groceries? Respect, man. Respect. Pulling out the back quote ad hominem when something makes them uncomfortable, attacking their character, rather than the argument itself. I see this at an alarming rate. Yes, but you're bad, so I won't believe this. Being rude to retail slash food workers. I work at an ice cream shop. I've worked a lot of food service jobs, burger joint. Pizza delivery, fast food, and this one has the least amount of jerks for sure. However, people can still be jerks at an ice cream shop. Like they are going to enjoy some ice cream and somehow get really mad. Right now we are not offering samples because of COVID and some people are so mad about it. One lady was like, show me the law or ordinance that says you can't serve samples right now. And I wanted to be like, show me the law that says you have a right to free samples. The worst one as of late was three people who sat on our private patio and started eating tequila from somewhere else. I went out and said, hey, are you planning on getting some ice cream? And this woman flipped out demanding the manager's and owner's phone numbers. Then all three of them left nasty reviews calling me out by name. It makes me really sad because I make so many people happy there and put in the extra effort to be kind and make it a fun experience. If kids are sad, I try to hype them up and ask like, do you want this spot with the extra cookie dough pieces? How about some free sprinkles? And they get happy and everyone is happy, but happy people don't leave reviews. I don't expect them to, but it bums me out that now there's three really bad reviews calling me out by name and only like three good reviews saying my name. Makes me wonder who would do that. I'm making $11 an hour. Why have a vendetta to take my job and embarrass me? They must have a sad, unfulfilled life. Happy people don't really leave reviews because they believe being good is ordinary and that they won't need to leave one because most people should know that's a good place. Bad reviews on these places are mostly left there because they got mad at something that was their problem. This is why I don't trust reviews. A one-star review could be anything from I don't like the way the busser looked at me to the waiter slapped me with a raw chicken leg and set my bag on fire. One-star reviews probably have a higher chance of being fake than two or three-star reviews. Most people who are overreacting and say they'll leave a bad review will always go with one-star reviews, leading to it becoming mostly fake overreactors. Not accepting slash admitting when they are wrong. Constant excuse or finger point instead of saying I was wrong. Conversely, never accepting it when someone admits they were wrong. This is infuriating to the nth degree. It's just so charming to have your own faults shoved into your face. I already acknowledged I messed up. What's the point in rubbing it in? It shows the world far more about the other person. Unless it's something where the person hopes they can get away with bad behavior just because they offered a half-assed apology. Leave them be. Changing lanes without signaling or looking. And doing it slowly on top of that. I can't stand it when people just mosey on over. I'm still learning how to drive, and while I do signal and look, I sometimes end up going too slow because I'm afraid of hitting or being hit. It's worth being cautious here. Too many drivers treat a signal light as a hurry up and zoom past this guy before it's too late indicator. Had a guy do that to me when I was a new driver. There was a space. I was so cautious about it. And then some psycho gunned it and forced me out of the lane I was about halfway into. I got a good one. Two lanes. One perfectly empty. The other one is me plus a pickup truck directly behind me. I signal to change lanes. And the truck suddenly floors it. Crosses lanes and zooms past me. Dude cold just stayed in the lane and then passed instead of nearly killing us both. Makes no sense. Parents that force their kids to make sacrifices so that they can live the life that they want. Look, son. You throw the goat into the volcano for the chaos god. Daddy's got some lottery tickets to win. Apostrophe. Use for the you god. Goats for the goat throne. Milk for the cornflakes. Littering. And. Littering. And. Littering. And. Cheating on your spouse. My brother-in-law has 3 kids with my sister and has always had at least one girlfriend. When my sister found out, he asked if there was any way she could make it work with him having a girlfriend. She asked him how he did it. His response was, "You have to know how to play the game." And I'm fucking gored coward. Soon to be ex-brother-in-law. Pretty much. I hate to say it, but probably not. She has 3 kids with him and wants to keep him even with a girlfriend. I mean, unless he dies, they can divorce so she can move on. He's still their dad and he is a good dad. He's just a player. He should look into polygamy. Having a conversation on the phone with it on speaker in public. Skipping lines. Or trying to get into public transport while not everyone is out yet. Simon Sinek had a TED talk where he gave an anecdote about seeing a line of marathon runners waiting in line for a bagels after their run. And he didn't like the idea of waiting. So he went right to the table with the bagels and cut someone to get 2 bagels. And it was supposed to be an example of not following the rules and making you a good leader. It just made me think he was a douchebag for not waiting in line like a courteous person. Judge, Mr. Sinek, how do you plead? Simon Sinek, some rules are meant to be broken, judge. You killed 8 people. A terrible person in the midst of self-discovery. Best answer. Littering. Cigarette butts in particular for me. Knowing 100% that what you are doing is wrong and immoral, but doing it anyway. The fuckwits who PM the posters in the r/molested, r/abuse, r/mdsa, r/coxa, r/adult-server-force-of-abuse, etc. threads and ask for all the details, tw. As a brief example, so how many times a day did you do X? Did you like it? To males. Did you get hard? To females. Did you get wet? Do you still have nude photos of yourself from that age? I could go on, but I'm disgusted enough. What the fuck is wrong with people? WTF. I hope there's a reporting process for predators like that. Well, they can get reported to the moderators, but it's not like the moderators can throw them in jail. Being rude to people in the service industry. It's like they forget that servers, waitstaff, hostesses etc. are everyday people just trying to make a living. Just because they are serving you doesn't mean you're elevated to the status of kings and queens and deserved everything just because you want it. Anyone who says hurtful things slash makes wildly inappropriate jokes, then later when confronted, deny anything happened. Or they say stuff like, it was just a joke. Stop making a big deal out of it. That's called scrudding as doubt your bag. Cheating and being constantly hypocritical. Leaving shopping carts out in the parking lot. Honking at someone as soon as the light turns green and then dangerously cutting them off cause they weren't moving fast enough. Is it really worth 5 seconds of your life to get that fed up? Happens constantly here. Personally, I only honk at green lights after a 3-second count. 3 seconds is reasonable. And it's a toot, not a full honk. People who send death threats to people getting cancelled, and when they turn out to be innocent they are nowhere to be found. Cancel culture just in general. Men who take off the condom during sex. And women who fake being on birth control. Why would anyone do that? To get a guy to stay with them, or save a relationship. It happened to my ex-boyfriend. His wife claimed she forgot to take her pill one day and they ended up with a kid. They got divorced when their kid was 2. Damn, some people have an odd interpretation of the word save.